Whether or not you believe in a biblical hell, a lot of musicians emit low vibrations of evil and destruction, which are forced upon our youth by the music industry. One does not have to be a genius to understand what effect this has on young people's minds and their way of seeing things. Music is very powerful, and used in a wrong way it can change a whole generation in a way that may have catastrophic consequences. With morals and ethics gone, what remains is anarchy and chaos, the desired state the Illuminati wants the world to be in before the takeover. By making rebels out of our teenagers and have them go against their parents, the Illuminati is trying to dissolve the family unit, which is a very strong bond. As long as families stick together and the parents teach their children morals and ethics, the elite will have a very hard time to control us. And they know it. David Bowie in Rolling Stone magazine, February 12, 1976, stunned the music world, when he stated rock has always been the devil's music. I believe rock and roll is dangerous, I feel we're only heralding something even darker than ourselves. Rocker Frank Zappa, who discovered the awful truth December 4, 1993, the second he died proudly boasted, "I'm the devil's advocate. We have our own worshippers who are called groupies. Girls will give their bodies to musicians as you would give a sacrifice to a god." Peter's Brothers, What About Christian Rock, pages 17. The supergroup, Metallica, in the song Jump in the Fire, commands young people to jump into hell. "Follow me now, my child, do just as I say, jump by your will or be taken by force, I'll get you either way. So reach down, grab my hand, walk with me through the land, come home where you belong, so come on, jump in the fire." In the cover song, The Prince, Metallica openly sing, "Angel from below, I wish to sell my soul, devil take my soul, with diamonds you rip it, I don't care for heaven, so don't you look for me to cry, and I will burn in hell from the day I die." Proudly boasts, "Hopefully, I'll be remembered as the person who brought an end to Christianity." Spin, August 1996, pages 34. Manson, an ordained reverend in the Church of Satan, which is nothing more than a false representation of Satanism, it's just a way to recruit teenagers into the occult. Manson mutilates himself on stage, rips up the Holy Bible, and spews blasphemies against the Lord Jesus Christ. Manson's t-shirts declare, "Kill your parents." Manson claims his album Antichrist Superstar came via supernatural inspiration. "I heard this album is finished, I heard it in dreams, it was like the revelations of John the Baptist or something." Huh, October 1996, pages 34. Manson's hope for Antichrist Superstar. "I think every time people listen to this new album, maybe God will be destroyed in their heads." Huh, October 1996, pages 37. Manson's blasphemy is not just an act. Manson readily admits there's more to the show than meets the eye. "I don't know if anyone has really understood what we're trying to do. This isn't just about shock value, that's just there to lure the people in. Once we've got them, we can give them our message." Hit Parader, October 1996, pages 28. Manson admits his childhood longing for Satan. "My mom used to tell me when I was a kid, if you curse at nighttime, the devil's going to come to you when you're sleeping. I used to get excited because I really wanted it to happen, I wanted it. I Wanted It More Than Anything, Rolling Stone, January 23, 1997, pages 52. The band Twisted Sister sings, Burn in Hell. Welcome to the abandoned land, come on in child, take my hand. Here there's no work or play, only one bill to pay. There's just five words to say as you go down, 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 you're gonna burn in hell. Bon Jovi sings in Homebound Train. When I was just a boy, the devil took my hand, took me from my home, he made me a man. I'm going down, 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 down on a homebound train. In Smash Hits magazine, Bon Jovi says, I'd kill my mother for rock and roll. I would sell my soul. One of the most popular metal bands in rock history is Slayer. Slayer sings of themselves, in the song Show No Mercy, as warriors from the gates of hell, in Lord Satan we trust. Slayer's albums sell in the millions. And song after song is a praise to Satan. Their song Hell Awaits says, Jesus knows your soul cannot be saved, crucify the so-called Lord, he soon shall fall to me, your souls are damned, your God has fell to slave for me eternally, hell awaits. One of the top songs of the 70s was Hotel California by the Eagles. Most people have no idea the song refers to the Church of Satan, which happens to be located in a converted hotel on California Street. On the inside of the album cover, looking down on the festivities, is Anton LaVey, the founder of the Church of Satan and author of the Satanic Bible. People say, the Eagles aren't serious, they're just selling records. That's what you think. The Eagles manager, Larry Salter, admitted in the Waco Tribune Herald, February 28, 1982, that the Eagles were involved with the Church of Satan. Not surprisingly, one of the Eagles' songs is titled Have a Good Day in Hell. The group Kiss leaped on stage as rock and roll demons, spitting blood, breathing fire and screaming, God of rock and roll, we'll steal your virgin soul. In their song God of Thunder, they command young people to kneel before Satan. I'm Lord of the Wasteland, a modern-day man of steel. I gather darkness to please me and I command you to kneel before the God of Thunder, the God of Rock and Roll. I'll steal your virgin soul. Peter Criss, the drummer for Kiss, said in a TV Guide interview, I find myself evil. I believe in the devil as much as God. You can use either one to get things done. One of the most popular groups in rock is AC/DC. In the song, Hell's Bells, they sing, I got my bell, I'm gonna take you to hell, I'm gonna get you, Satan get you. Their song Highway to Hell they sing, Hey Satan paying my dues, playing in a rockin' band, Hey mama look at me, I'm on the way to the promised land, I'm on the highway to hell. Angus Young, lead guitarist for AC/DC, is called the Guitar Demon. and he admitted that something takes control of the band during their concerts. "It's like I'm on automatic pilot. By the time we're halfway through the first number, someone else is steering me. I'm just along for the ride. I become possessed when I get on stage." Hit Parader, July 1985, pages 60. The demonic Led Zeppelin. Guitarist Jimmy Page of Zeppelin is a devout follower of Satanist, Aleister Crowley, who proclaimed himself as the Beast 666. In 1971, guitarist Jimmy Page bought Crowley's Bullskin house on the shore of Loch Ness, where Crowley practiced his hellish, satanic sex magic rituals, including human sacrifices. Jimmy Page opened a bookshop venture for occult books called Equinox at 4, on Holland Street, in Kensington, London. The Led Zeppelin song, Stairway to Heaven, played backwards can be heard to say, "My sweet Satan. The one will be sad who makes me sad, whose power is Satan." Forward the lyrics say, "Yes, there are two paths you can go by. But in the long run there's still time to change the road you're on. Listen for yourself, and you be the judge." The song has not been altered in any way. If you think this is just a hoax, then try it for yourself. The group Suicidal Tendencies, whose songs glorify suicide and have been linked to teen suicides, reveal a frightening truth in the song Possessed. "I'm a prisoner of a demon, it stays with me wherever I go. I can break away from its hold. This must be my punishment for selling my soul." The song Sympathy for the Devil by the Rolling Stones is the official anthem for the Church of Satan. In it, Lucifer speaks in the first person and asks sympathy for all who meet him. Lead singer Mick Jagger claims that Anton LaVey, the founder of the Church of Satan and author of the Satanic Bible, helped inspire their music. Their album titled, Their Satanic Majesty's Request, leaves no doubt to their allegiance. "The more I research the history of rock and roll, the more I am shocked as to just how satanic the whole industry is. Few people would think of the Beach Boys as being involved with witchcraft, but as you will learn in this video, they certainly were. We were doing witchcraft, trying to make witchcraft music." Brian Wilson quoted in Nick Kent's The Dark Stuff, pages 27. As with many other rockers, Santana admits that there is a spiritual entity behind his music. Santana claims that he has had contact with the dead spirit of Jimi Hendrix. Santana claims that his first initiation into the spiritual world took place when he first ingested the illegal drug LSD in the 1960s. Other musicians, such as Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys, claim to have experienced type of spirit control. Santana claims that while he played Woodstock, the mecca of rock and roll, his guitar became a serpent before his eyes and inspired the way he played, which has made him famous as a rock guitarist. Santana admits that his success is tied to a spiritual entity, Metatron. Thus, Santana is of the devil. Through meditation, Santana said in Rolling Stone magazine, March 16, 2000, pages 41, the demonic spirits tell him what to write for his lyrics and music. "You meditate and you got the candles, you got the incense and you've been chanting, and all of a sudden you hear this voice. Write this down." In his autobiography The Dog Father, Snoop Dogg says the devil came to him to make a deal that he would be rich and famous in exchange for his soul. Snoop accepted the devil's offer, by his own words, and identifies at the point at which Calvin Brodus dies Snoop Dogg was born. Ozzy Osbourne was a high school dropout and juvenile delinquent who spent time in prison for theft before he made his deal with the devil. Osbourne claims that he was drawn to Satan from the time of his childhood. "I've always had this thing about Satan from the time I was small. The devil is within us all the time." Circus, August 26, 1980, pages 26. Sadly, Ozzy sought to find acceptance and success by opening himself up to dark satanic powers that are always seeking to exploit willing and open mediums. Ozzy would admit at the pinnacle of his success with Black Sabbath that he believed he was a medium for forces greater than himself who had given him such fame and accomplishment. Ozzy stated, "I don't know if I'm a medium for some outside source. Whatever it is, frankly, I hope it's not what I think, Satan." Hit Parader, February 1975, pages 24. The spirit behind most secular music is satanic. Many artists have admitted to selling their souls to Satan for fame and fortune. Many artists have also admitted themselves to channeling or being a conduit for evil spirits to create or perform their music. Remember, these are the artists saying themselves and the people around them that have said they are possessed or feel like the music is channeled through them. Tori Amos said, "I think music comes through dimensions. It's arrogant to think you can create music on your own. There's a co-creation going on. I don't know with whom, but there is this well that we all tap into." She once said, "I wanted to marry Lucifer. I don't consider Lucifer an evil force. I feel his presence with his music. I feel like he comes and sits on my piano." She even made a song dedicated to Lucifer. In the following performance, this should pretty much say it all. Apparently gets her music from demons. She said herself that she has the spirit of her dead aunt living inside her, which is really a demon, and that the spirit of Alexander McQueen wrote a song for her called Judas, where I presume she expresses sympathy for Judas who betrayed Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. She also says she bought a Ghostbuster machine worth thousands of dollars because she said she is convinced evil spirits are haunting her. She also expressed that she had terrible nightmares with occult imagery, but she would use it as inspiration for her stage acts, which would consist of a mock self-sacrifice and hanging by noose. Satan is obviously using Gaga for his agenda, brainwashing the masses.
I have no relation to the lyrical content of my music.
Sometimes they don't want to, and they're, you know, Gaga, we can't get, you know, the frequency's weird, and, you know, it's sounding a little bit strange. And I'm like, if you don't get this right now, I swear to Lucifer, I'm gonna, you know, I get a little bit mad.
John Lennon is believed to have sold his soul or made a deal with the devil. In fact, he said it himself. There is even a book about it called The Lennon Prophecy. The Beatles channeled evil spirits as those in his inner circle revealed. John Lennon once said, "When the real music comes to me, it has nothing to do with cause. I'm just a channel. It's given to me and I transcribe it like a channel." He once referred to himself as a hollow temple in which the spirits would inhabit him, then leave to be inhabited by another. When asked why the Beatles were so successful, he said himself, "I sold my soul to the devil." Kurt Cobain did say his life's goal was to get stoned and worship Satan. Kurt Cobain was obsessed with Satanist Anton LaVey. Cobain even wanted LaVey to record a song with him. Cobain was known to desecrate churches by writing "God is gay" and other blasphemies. It was reported that he was involved in witchcraft. Indeed, he did channel demons, as Cobain is described as stumbling on melodies by means he himself didn't fully understand. His widow, after his suicide, would state that Kurt had a lot of personal inner expletive deleted demons, a lot of frailties and physical ailments. Sanford would state in his biography, "He was a diffident, yet aggressive personality who struggled with demons that drove and tormented him." It's said that Cobain killed himself because the demonic entities stopped channeling lyrics through him. In his suicide note he would write, "I haven't felt the excitement of listening to as well as creating music, along with really writing, for too many years now." Sanford has stated, in his suicide note, Cobain despaired that his muse had flown south. Jimi Hendrix believed he was possessed by demonic spirits. His girlfriend admitted it as well. His producer also stated that he believed he was possessed. Hendrix begged his girlfriend for help, and he felt that the voices in his head were tormenting him. Jimi Hendrix said in Life magazine, October 30, 1969, "I can explain everything better through music. You hypnotize people, and when you get people at their weakest point, you can preach into their subconscious what we want to say. That's why the name Electric Church flashes in and out." Beyoncé confessed that is controlled by an external force. She calls the entity Sasha Fierce. She said it takes control of her when she performs on stage. It has been said that in one performance she was angry after a performance because Sasha Fierce threw a ring on her finger to the audience. Along with her new album, Beyoncé has presented her fans to a new alter ego named Sasha Fierce. The singer affirms that this new persona is the fun, more sexual and more aggressive side of her. This is, however, the general public version of the story. The esoteric meaning revealed by the symbols surrounding this new persona is much deeper. Sasha Fierce is a symbolic representation of an artist taken over by evil to obtain success. Beyoncé goes on to say, "I have someone else that takes over when it's time for me to work and when I'm on stage, this alter ego that I've created that kind of protects me and who I really am."
Perfect. Sasha is my alter ego. And when people see me, sometimes I think that when they meet me and they speak with me, they're expecting Sasha. And I'm really kind of shy, and not really shy, but more reserved, and nothing like Sasha. But I guess I wouldn't be very entertaining on the stage, so Sasha comes out, and she's fearless. You know, she can do things that I cannot do when I'm in rehearsal. I mean, I can try, but then it just doesn't happen. I can sing notes and sing strong and do all these things that when I'm just by myself, I can't do. And I remember right before I performed, I raised my hands up, and it was kind of the first time I felt something else come into me. And I knew that was gonna be my coming out night for the BET Awards.
Jim Morrison himself believed he was a sort of a shaman and that spirits used him for his music. His producer Paul Rothschild said that the most pivotal part of his life is when this spirit entered him. This is all stated in the book Break On Through the Life and Death of Jim Morrison. At Venice Beach before he became famous, he said in that year there was an intense visitation of energy. "I left school and went down to the beach to live. Slept on a roof, I met the spirit of music. An appearance of the devil on a Venice canal. Running, I saw Satan.
You're doing really well now, but didn't you release a CD like almost 10 years ago?
I released a gospel record when I was 15 because I grew up in a household where all I ever did was listen to gospel music, and my parents are both traveling ministers, and so I kind of sang about, you know, what was going on in my life at 15, and that's how I got introduced to the music industry. Because I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
Little Richard has testified that rock music is demonic. My true belief about rock and roll, and there have been a lot of phrases attributed to me over the years, is this: I believe this kind of music is demonic. A lot of the beats in music today are taken from voodoo, from the voodoo drums. If you study music and rhythms, like I have, you'll see that is true. I believe that kind of music is driving people from Christ. It is contagious. Little Richard, quoted by Charles White, The Life and Times of Little Richard, pages 197. I was directed and commanded by another power. The power of darkness, the power that a lot of people don't believe exists. The power of the devil. Satan. Little Richard, quoted in The Life and Times of Little Richard, pages 205 and 206. Eminem said he sold his soul in his rap song Goodbye Hollywood. What about math? How come I was never good at that? It's like the boy in the bubble, who never could adapt. I'm trapped. If I could go back, I never would have rapped. I sold my soul to the devil. I'll never get it back. I just wanna leave this game with leveled head intact.
I sat on a council of 13 people that take orders only from the Rothschild Tribunal in London, which they claim they take their orders directly from Lucifer.
I was the manager of Zodiac Productions, which Zodiac Productions' name's been changed since then. I'm not even sure what to call it now, but it's the largest music conglomerate in the world. It owns RCA Records, Columbia Records, Motown Records, owns almost all the concert booking agencies in the United States. And that's not even the name of the company that owns it. The name of the company that owns it is Brenner Enterprises, and Brenner Enterprises is owned by Chase Manhattan. Chase Manhattan's owned by Standard Oil, and Standard Oil's owned by the Lords of London. You can track it all back. You kind of get the idea after a while. But I was the managing president of Zodiac Productions. It was one of my jobs as being one of these 13 people. Thus, I got to know many of the people who produce music and sing the music and play the music that you play. Now, one of the closest friends that I got during that time that I obtained was a man named David Crosby, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. I saw David the day before Christmas last year, talked with him. I got him away from this witch that he had with him. He told her to go shopping. We were in West Hollywood, and I was witnessing around to people I knew. We went off in this store, and we started talking. I said, David, I'd like to ask you a couple questions. I said, I already know the answers, but I've been gone for 5 years. I'd like to know if certain things are still the way they were when I left. I said, I'll have to explain some of this when I'm done, because you're not going to understand it all unless you know something about music. I said, do they still take the master to the temple room? Dave said, yeah. I said, do they still have the coven conjure demons into the master? He said, of course. I said, now, I got to know something. What's the main reason for rock music? He said, come on, Lance, you know what the reason is. I said, please, David, I don't want to guess. Tell me what the main reason is. He says, the same as when you were in, so that we can place spells on people that we couldn't cast spells upon. I'll explain what that means in a minute. I said, okay, one last thing. I've been hearing that you must be an initiated witch now to get a record contract. He said, that's right. He says, many of us that weren't total witches have to be witches now in order to produce music. Thank you. The master is a tape about as big as the top of this podium that looks like an overgrown 8-track that the album is cut on and is placed in a machine that produces and presses the records and the 8-tracks and cassettes that you buy. After it's been recorded, it's taken in. This is why a master is cut months in advance before it's released. On the full moon, it's taken in to a temple room about the size of this auditorium that is in every one of the major music companies behind locked doors up in the executive offices, and it's placed on an altar sitting in the north of the room and a pentagram engraved in the floor. And 13 hand-chosen witches and wizards and a coven come in and conjure a principality or a power up, usually region or something like that, and order him to tell the demons under him to follow every record and every tape coming off of that master. As I tell many Christian parents, you can go home and count your kids' records, probably yours too, and count how many demons at least are there. If that's too hard for you to believe, I'm sorry. That's why they do it. Now listen to me. This is why rock music is addicting. Have you ever seen kids that got rid of their music? They go around like this. They can't wait to find a rock station somewhere and they sneak off just like getting a cigarette or a fix because it's addicting. That's why they can't give it up. The rest of the conversation was this. You can't cast a spell on a Christian, but you can get a Christian to cast a spell on themselves. If you give the permission for the spell to work, being a Christian won't block it. And rock music is not just a song. It is supernatural music that which is carefully designed by their spirit guides or familiar spirits in the form of spells. Now, although the devil's music's power is the music and God's music is the word, much of the songs are written in what we call witch language. To give you kind of an idea, you talk on, many of you talk on a CB, unless you know what you, what a smoky is, and a 10-4, and a front door and back door and rocking chair and these type of things, you don't know what you're talking about. Same with witches. When you're in the first and second level, you have to learn over 2,000 words that said by anybody else means something totally different than when you say them. Elton John has said he's never written a song or sung a song that wasn't in witch language. And I want to show you something. See how many kids in here will be honest and adults. How many remember and have heard at least several times a song called Hotel California? Somebody tell me what it meant. Quickly, somebody tell me what it meant. Huh? That's pretty close. But from the word, what did it mean? Well, that's more of a guess. See, most people can't tell you. That's why when people do drugs and they listen to songs in which language, they get some of the meaning. But most of the time, they can't tell you. Stop and think how many songs are out there that you really like, and you don't have any idea what the person was talking about. Beyond the Yellow Brick Road? How about The Destroyer by Kiss? Can anybody tell me what it's about? Kiss said in it, kids, tell your parents. They're talking about Helter Skelter. Beatles sung Helter Skelter in which language? Nobody knew what it meant. Manson did because he belonged to the process. Helter Skelter is a several thousand year old word. Most of the music is either about Helter Skelter or a place called the Night Winds, which is what Hotel California is about, and different doctrines of witchcraft. You listen to them, your parents let you listen to them, and they have no idea. Kiss openly bragged how they were gaining control of people through their music because the people played their music. They told how they didn't form their own group. Their church, because they were ordained ministers of the Satanist church, placed them together. And that's how most of the music is done. David Crosby, when him and Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young produced the record 283, they ordered the principality of Medea to order demons of rebellion to go into the record, and everybody that heard it would be rebellious against law and order and government. And it was one of the reasons for the great upheaval in the 60s was that one album, and they take open credit for it.
Michael Jackson was heavily involved in the occult. He admitted he had a room full of mirrors so he could communicate with the spirit. Jackson said he would go to sleep for days with the aid of drugs so he can get songs from the spirits, or else the music of the spirits would be given to Prince. Jackson said, "I wake up from dreams and go, wow, put this down on paper, the whole thing is strange. You hear the words, everything is right there in front of your face. I feel that somewhere, someplace it's been done, and I'm just a courier bringing it into the world." Michael Jackson, Rolling Stone, February 17, 1983.
How do you write a song? How do you write a song?
How do I write a song? Well,
you don't have a pen in your hand and you don't try. What would happen?
If I sat here and played some chords, whatever, and say, I'm going to write the best song I've ever written, nothing happens. Something in the heavens has to say, look, this is the time that this is going to be laid on you, and this is when I want you to have it. Now, I remember when I wrote Billie Jean, I was riding in my car down Ventura Boulevard. All I said to myself beforehand, I want to write a song with a great bass hook, you know. And and I just let it go, really. And then several days later, you know, you know, the
Where
holy...
Where did that come from?
From above.
So, okay, you were singing the bass line. Sing that again, and then what happened? How did you get the other instrumentation and the composition? How did it work?
See, the thing is, in artists seem to get in the way of the music. Get out of the way of the music. You know, don't write the music. Let the music write itself.
Prince admitted he had two other people living inside him, really evil spirits, and that he changed his name to formerly known as Prince because he didn't know what the spirits wanted to call him. Rapper Jay-Z shown here wearing a shirt that is displaying Aleister Crowley's Do What Thy Wilt satanic motto. Even though Jay-Z denies being involved in the occult, Jay-Z has been caught several times with his hand in the Illuminati cookie jar. He named his record company Rockefeller Records, naming it after the infamous Illuminati family, the Rockefellers. Jay-Z even released a song paying homage to Lucifer, entitled Lucifer.
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
In one interview, Van Halen's David Lee Roth said, I'm gonna abandon my spirit to them, which is exactly what I attempt to do. You work yourself up into that state and you fall into supplication of the demon gods. Guitarist Mick Mars of Motley Crue described this band as demonic. That's what we are, in Heavy Metal Times, May 1983. Nikki Sixx, referring to their Shout at the Devil stage show, commented, we have skulls, pentagrams, and all kinds of satanic symbols on stage. I've always flirted with the devil in Circus magazine, January 31, 1984. Griffey, the producer for Dr. Dre, said, I was there when Dre said he sold his soul to the devil for $1 million. And I swear, the devil got a receipt for his ass. Rapper Lil Wayne doesn't seem to be hiding the fact that he is a Satanist in his video for Love Me featuring Future and Drake, a song in which Wayne says these hoes love me like Satan, basically saying that Satan loves him. The video is disturbing to say the least, complete with evil imagery including women bathing in blood. The video also features demonic-looking women locked up in cages. Some of the women even have reptilian-like forked tongues thanks to computer graphics. The flame from the lighter at the beginning of the video creates a silhouette of Baphomet. And a satanic music video wouldn't be complete without the all-seeing eye being symbolized by the covering of one eye. This model's eye is even being covered by a butterfly, the symbol for monarch mind control programming. Miley Cyrus' dad, Billy Ray Cyrus, told GQ he is scared for his daughter's future in the spotlight. On February 15, 2011, Billy Ray Cyrus told GQ, my family is under attack by Satan, I'm scared for my daughter Miley. Billy Ray didn't place all the blame on those currently in Miley's life. There are also evil forces at work, he claimed. Somewhere along this journey, both mine and Miley's faith has been shaken, he said. It saddens me the most. His family, Billy Ray argued, is now being ruined by Satan. No doubt, he insisted. There's no doubt about it.
And of course, Rihanna is in the building.
Hey, Angie.
I cannot believe it's been so long that we have done this.
You know, I am misunderstood a lot at times. My music, my image, people have their whole thing about me, whether it be me being a devil worshiper or whatever, besides them reading into my hand over my eye on my album cover.
Why is your hand over your eye?
Because I'm a devil worshiper. What are you talking about?
Kesha admits she worships Satan in her song Dancing with the Devil. This shouldn't come as a surprise, though, because the pop star has posted pictures on her Facebook page of her wearing satanic pentagram earrings, and it's pretty obvious if you know anything about her. Nicki Minaj admits to being possessed by a demon spirit named Roman. Just when you thought the whole Illuminati demon possession by certain artists was a hoax. You may change your mind when you watch this confession from Nicki Minaj as she talks about the demon spirit that lives inside of her.
Demon is a crazy boy who lives in me. And he says the things that I don't want to say. He was born, you know, just a few months ago. I think he was born out of rage. He was conceived in rage. So he bashes everyone. He threatens to beat people, and he's violent.
That must be nice to have, like, an ignorant loudmouth who you can just sort of blame every...
He wants to be blamed. I don't want to blame him. I ask him to leave, but he can't. He's here for a reason. People have brought him out. People conjured him up. Now he won't leave.
Satan even offered Jesus the kingdoms of the world. If Jesus worshipped him, so surely he can offer people fame and fortune if you served him. Satan is using music to pull people away from God and to corrupt people's hearts and souls. Satan certainly has musical abilities. It is believed he was a minister of music in heaven before he got kicked out because iniquity was found in him. This can be found in Ezekiel 28:13.
Dave Mustaine is one of the gods of metal, a founding member of Metallica, and the founder and frontman for Megadeth. He says he has no doubt about the devil.
The greatest lie he's ever told was convincing people he doesn't exist. And you see people, they think that he's like red. He's got a goatee and a pointy tail and stuff like that. He doesn't. He's very beautiful. He's an angel. Why would he look like some monster? He's capable of looking just like you. He could be in this room right now. We wouldn't know it.
That's a scary thought.
It's a very scary thought.
Mustaine is currently on tour in Europe with what's called the Big Four, his current and former bands, plus Anthrax and Slayer. Are people right when they say that heavy metal music is infused with the power of the devil?
In some cases, yes. But yes. Not in all cases, because you've got great heavy metal bands that believe in God and glorify him. We pray every night before we go on stage.
That sounds great.
For a 50-year-old,
you happy with it?
50-year-old man, I feel pretty damn good.
He shows me a chord progression called the tritone, also known as the devil's interval.
The devil's tritone is made up of these three notes, and this note right here drops down one. So it goes. So listen to the difference. It just sounds evil, doesn't it?
It sounds darker.
Which is why the progression is used so frequently in death metal. Mustaine says he is a Christian now, but wasn't always.
My mom was a Jehovah's Witness. I was brought up as a witness, and I revolted into the witchcraft because I hated going out and knocking on people's doors.
Yes, witchcraft. As a teenager, Mustaine says, he cast two hexes. The first was on a bully who sucker punched him.
From what I heard, he got in a car accident, and something happened to part of his body that I had targeted in the hex, and that showed me that it was real.
The second was on a girl he was in a class with.
Everybody wanted her, including me, but she was so out of my batting average and just totally out of my league. And I did it, and the next day she was in my apartment.
You were convinced that these hexes, that you were spells that you were casting, worked.
I was, and I do believe in the dark side. Most people think that, you know, black magic and witchcraft and stuff like that isn't real or it doesn't work, and I know that it works.
Mustaine's fascination with the occult continued into his adulthood.
I was doing a lot of blood packs with people. This is before we found out about AIDS. It was real simple stuff where you cut your thumb and you rub it with somebody else and become blood brothers. I don't want to make a spiritual covenant and mixing my life with somebody else who I don't know who they are, how they are. The Bible said that blood is life.
And like so many people we have met, Mustaine believes that he opened the door to demonic forces, which had a profound impact on his life.
Was your abuse of alcohol related to the satanic influences that you'd been dabbling in?
I'll say this. Every time I drank, I did not always do activities that were satanic, but any time I had been doing anything that was satanic, I had been drinking.
So there
does
was
that make sense?
Yes, it does. There was a relationship then.
Absolutely.
There are some songs Mustaine will no longer sing. I am an
antichrist. Like Megadeth's cover of the Sex Pistols' Anarchy in the UK. And he says he believes he's better for it.
I think that I'm more dangerous now that I've become a Christian than I ever was before when I was trying to go the opposite route, because I'm armed with the truth now.
We only have to look around us at the music industry and its rock, rap and pop stars to see how much of an influence Satan has on music and its corruption. It is most certainly one of the devil's strongest tools to corrupt the word of God and influence the lost away from godliness and to place strongholds on them via music. The signs and symbols are prevalent in music videos and in stage performances. Spiritual warfare is certainly going on. Ephesians 6:12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. There is a battle going on for your soul. The choice is either Jesus Christ or Satan. So should Christians listen to secular mainstream music? The answer is no. Ephesians 5:11. Have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. Everyone loves music. What is the first thing you do after you start your car? Turn on the radio. What is playing in the background at every store, restaurant, or theme park you visit? Music is also used to move emotions. In weight rooms you have heavy driving music, in sports arenas you have music that gets you excited, and during the holiday season you have Christmas music to get you into the spirit to spend money. I could go on and on. So how could so many people say music doesn't influence people? Ask a school full of kids how many watch MTV and you will instantly see a sea of hands rise. Bob Pittman, the co-founder of MTV, which has become one of the most profitable and influential TV networks of all time, stated, "The strongest appeal you can make is emotionally. If you can get their emotions going, you've got them. At MTV we don't shoot for the 14-year-olds, we own them." So, if Bob Pittman owns his viewers, you would think that he would care for them as a parent figure and want to see them succeed in life. Yet, try and name just three bands MTV endorses that promote good morals through their music on a consistent basis. You cannot. The sad fact is that Pittman's network has more influence over today's youth than most parents do. Kids act, talk, dress, carry the same attitudes, and aspire to be just like their favorite musicians. At Woodstock in 1999, 500 riot police had to stop the concert because of violence. 12 trailers and one stage were burned to the ground, dozens of sexual assaults and rapes occurred, 44 people were arrested, hundreds of people were treated on site for minor injuries and 253 people were hospitalized for more serious wounds. When the band Limp Bizkit took the stage, frontman and lead vocalist Fred Durst introduced a new song titled, Break Stuff, by stating, "It's time to let yourself go right now because there's no rules out there." The majority of the chaos took place right after he said those words and the band started to play. Now, it is against the law to rape and to destroy other people's property, yet a musician can defy the law and tell the audience, "Do what you want." People no longer obeyed the laws but rather the voices of those who played the music. Durst once told Entertainment Weekly, "There are kids out there, they're gonna listen to every word I say." This Woodstock incident would suggest he is right. Take a look at what neurologist Dr. Richard Pellegrino was quoted as saying in the January 23, 1999 issue of Billboard magazine. Take it from a brain guy. In 25 years of working with the brain, I still cannot affect a person's state of mind the way one simple song can. You may need to ask yourself if you are under the influence. According to the book, Satanism in America, which is endorsed by the National Criminal Justice Task Force on Occult-Related Ritualistic Crimes, hardcore Satanism is the fastest-growing subculture among America's teens. Studies taken by the Georgia Police Academy revealed 90% of those involved in Satanism are teenagers. Television personality Geraldo Rivera, who explored the terrifying rise of Satanism, said, "It exists and it's flourishing. It is teenagers who are most likely to fall under the spell of Satanism. If you haven't done so yet, then there is no better time than now to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. It is faith in Jesus Christ that is the only way to eternal salvation, and Satan knows that by destroying your faith, he will have your soul for all of eternity." Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Please subscribe to the channel, and like us, and follow us on Facebook and Twitter. We need all the support we can get. Remember, Jesus saves. God bless. Whether or not you believe in a biblical hell, a lot of musicians emit low vibrations of evil and destruction, which are forced upon our youth by the music industry. One does not have to be a genius to understand what effect this has on young people's minds and their way of seeing things. Music is very powerful, and used in a wrong way, it can change a whole generation in a way that may have catastrophic consequences. With morals and ethics gone, what remains is anarchy and chaos, the desired state the Illuminati wants the world to be in before the takeover. By making rebels out of our teenagers and have them go against their parents, the Illuminati is trying to dissolve the family unit, which is a very strong bond. As long as families stick together and the parents teach their children morals and ethics, the elite will have a very hard time to control us. And they know it. David Bowie in Rolling Stone magazine, February 12, 1976, stunned the music world when he stated, "Rock has always been the devil's music. I believe rock and roll is dangerous. I feel we're only heralding something even darker than ourselves." Rocker Frank Zappa, who discovered the awful truth December 4, 1993, the second he died, proudly boasted, "I'm the devil's advocate. We have our own worshippers who are called groupies. Girls will give their bodies to musicians as you would give a sacrifice to a god." Peters Brothers, What About Christian Rock, pages 17. The supergroup, Metallica, in the song Jump in the Fire, commands young people to jump into hell. "Follow me now, my child, do just as I say, jump by your will or be taken by force, I'll get you either way. So reach down, grab my hand, walk with me through the land, come home where you belong, so come on, jump in the fire." In the cover song, The Prince, Metallica openly sing, "Angel from below, I wish to sell my soul, devil take my soul, with diamonds you rip a, I don't care for heaven, so don't you look for me to cry, and I will burn in hell from the day I die." Proudly boasts, "Hopefully, I'll be remembered as the person who brought an end to Christianity." Spin, August 1996, pages 34. Manson, an ordained reverend in the Church of Satan, which is nothing more than a false representation of Satanism. It's just a way to recruit teenagers into the occult. Manson mutilates himself on stage, rips up the Holy Bible, and spews blasphemies against the Lord Jesus Christ. Manson's t-shirts declare, "Kill your parents." Manson claims his album Antichrist Superstar came via supernatural inspiration. "I heard this album is finished. I heard it in dreams. It was like the revelations of John the Baptist or something." Huh. October 1996, pages 34. Manson's hope for Antichrist Superstar. "I think every time people listen to this new album, maybe God will be destroyed in their heads." Huh. October 1996, pages 37. Manson's blasphemy is not just an act. Manson readily admits there's more to the show than meets the eye. "I don't know if anyone has really understood what we're trying to do. This isn't just about shock value, that's just there to lure the people in. Once we've got them, we can give them our message." Hit Parader, October 1996, pages 28. Manson admits his childhood longing for Satan. "My mom used to tell me when I was a kid, if you curse at nighttime, the devil's going to come to you when you're sleeping. I used to get excited because I really wanted it to happen. I wanted it. I wanted it more than anything." Rolling Stone, January 23, 1997, pages 52. The band Twisted Sister sings, "Burn in Hell." "Welcome to the abandoned land, come on in child, take my hand. Here there's no work or play, only one bill to pay. There's just five words to say as you go down, 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 you're gonna burn in hell." Bon Jovi sings in Homebound Train. "When I was just a boy, the devil took my hand, took me from my home, he made me a man. I'm going down, 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 down on a homebound train." In Smash Hits magazine, Bon Jovi says, "I'd kill my mother for rock and roll. I would sell my soul." One of the most popular metal bands in rock history is Slayer. Slayer sings of themselves, in the song Show No Mercy, as "warriors from the gates of hell, in Lord Satan we trust." Slayer's albums sell in the millions. And song after song is a praise to Satan. Their song Hell Awaits says, "Jesus knows your soul cannot be saved, crucify the so-called Lord, he soon shall fall to me, your souls are damned, your God has fell to slave for me eternally, hell awaits." One of the top songs of the 70s was Hotel California by the Eagles. Most people have no idea the song refers to the Church of Satan, which happens to be located in a converted hotel on California Street. On the inside of the album cover, looking down on the festivities, is Anton LaVey, the founder of the Church of Satan and author of the Satanic Bible. People say, the Eagles aren't serious, they're just selling records. That's what you think. The Eagles manager, Larry Salter, admitted in the Waco Tribune Herald, February 20. Gets her music from demons. She said herself that she has a spirit of her dead aunt living inside her, which is really a demon, and that the spirit of Alexander McQueen wrote a song for her called Judas, where I presume she expresses sympathy for Judas who betrayed Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. She also says she bought a Ghostbuster machine worth thousands of dollars because she said she is convinced evil spirits are haunting her. She also expressed that she had terrible nightmares with occult imagery, but she would use it as inspiration for her stage acts, which would consist of a mock self-sacrifice and hanging by noose. Satan is obviously using Gaga for his agenda, brainwashing the masses.
I have no relation to the lyrical content of my music. Sometimes they don't want to, and they're, you know, Gaga, we can't get, you know, the frequency's weird, and, you know, it's sounding a little bit strange. And I'm like, if you don't get this right now, I swear to Lucifer, I'm gonna, you know, I get a little bit mad.
John Lennon is believed to have sold his soul or made a deal with the devil. In fact, he said it himself. There is even a book about it called The Lennon Prophecy. The Beatles channel evil spirits as those in his inner circle revealed. John Lennon once said, "When the real music comes to me, it has nothing to do with cause. I'm just a channel. It's given to me and I transcribe it like a channel." He once referred to himself as a hollow temple in which the spirits would inhabit him, then leave to be inhabited by another. When asked why the Beatles were so successful, he said himself, "I sold my soul to the devil." Kurt Cobain did say his life's goal was to get stoned and worship Satan. Kurt Cobain was obsessed with Satanist Anton LaVey. Cobain even wanted LaVey to record a song with him. Cobain was known to desecrate churches by writing "God is gay" and other blasphemies. It was reported that he was involved in witchcraft. Indeed, he did channel demons, as Cobain is described as stumbling on melodies by means he himself didn't fully understand. His widow, after his suicide, would state that Kurt had a lot of personal inner expletive deleted demons, a lot of frailties and physical ailments. Sanford would state in his biography, "He was a diffident, yet aggressive personality who struggled with demons that drove and tormented him." It's said that Cobain killed himself because the demonic entities stopped channeling lyrics through him. In his suicide note, he would write, "I haven't felt the excitement of listening to as well as creating music, along with really writing, for too many years now." Sanford has stated, in his suicide note, Cobain despaired that his muse had flown south. Jimi Hendrix believed he was possessed by demonic spirits. His girlfriend admitted it as well. His producer also stated that he believed he was possessed. Hendrix begged his girlfriend for help, and he felt that the voices in his head were tormenting him. Jimi Hendrix said in Life magazine, October 30, 1969, "I can explain everything better through music. You hypnotize people, and when you get people at their weakest point, you can preach into their subconscious what we want to say. That's why the name Electric Church flashes in and out." Beyoncé confessed that is controlled by an external force. She calls the entity Sasha Fierce. She said it takes control of her when she performs on stage. It has been said that in one performance she was angry after a performance because Sasha Fierce threw a ring on her finger to the audience. Along with her new album, Beyoncé has presented her fans to a new alter ego named Sasha Fierce. The singer affirms that this new persona is the fun, more sexual and more aggressive side of her. This is, however, the general public version of the story. The esoteric meaning revealed by the symbols surrounding this new persona is much deeper. Sasha Fierce is a symbolic representation of an artist taken over by evil to obtain success. Beyoncé goes on to say, "I have someone else that takes over when it's time for me to work and when I'm on stage, this alter ego that I've created that kind of protects me and who I really am."
Fact. Sasha is my alter ego. And when people see me, sometimes I think that when they meet me and they speak with me, they're expecting Sasha. And I'm really kind of shy, and not really shy, but more reserved, and nothing like Sasha. But I guess I wouldn't be very entertaining on the stage, so Sasha comes out, and she's fearless. You know, she can do things that I cannot do when I'm in rehearsal. I mean, I can try, but then it just doesn't happen. I can sing notes and sing strong and do all these things that when I'm just by myself, I can't do. And I remember right before I performed, I raised my hands up, and it was kind of the first time I felt something else come into me. And I knew that was gonna be my coming out night for the BET Awards.
Jim Morrison himself believed he was a sort of a shaman and that spirits used him for his music. His producer Paul Rothschild said that the most pivotal part of his life is when this spirit entered him. This is all stated in the book Break On Through the Life and Death of Jim Morrison. At Venice Beach before he became famous, he said in that year there was an intense visitation of energy. "I left school and went down to the beach to live. Slept on a roof, I met the spirit of music. An appearance of the devil on a Venice canal. Running, I saw Satan."
You're doing really well now, but didn't you release a CD like almost 10 years ago?
Yeah, I mean, I released a gospel record when I was 15 because I grew up in a household where all I ever did was listen to gospel music, and my parents are both traveling ministers, and so I kind of sang about, you know, what was going on in my life at 15, and that's how I got introduced to the music industry. Because I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
Little Richard has testified that rock music is demonic. "My true belief about rock and roll, and there have been a lot of phrases attributed to me over the years, is this: I believe this kind of music is demonic. A lot of the beats in music today are taken from voodoo, from the voodoo drums. If you study music and rhythms, like I have, you'll see that is true. I believe that kind of music is driving people from Christ. It is contagious." Little Richard, quoted by Charles White, The Life and Times of Little Richard, pages 197. "I was directed and commanded by another power. The power of darkness, the power that a lot of people don't believe exists. The power of the devil. Satan." Little Richard, quoted in The Life and Times of Little Richard, pages 205 and 206. Eminem said he sold his soul in his rap song Goodbye Hollywood. "What about math? How come I was never good at that? It's like the boy in the bubble, who never could adapt. I'm trapped. If I could go back, I never would have rapped. I sold my soul to the devil. I'll never get it back. I just wanna leave this game with level head intact." 28th, 1982, that the Eagles were involved with the Church of Satan. Not surprisingly, one of the Eagles' songs is titled Have a Good Day in Hell. The group Kiss leaped on stage as rock and roll demons, spitting blood, breathing fire and screaming, "God of rock and roll, we'll steal your virgin soul." In their song God of Thunder, they command young people to kneel before Satan. I'm Lord of the Wasteland, a modern-day man of steel. I gather darkness to please me and I command you to kneel before the God of Thunder, the God of Rock and Roll. I'll steal your virgin soul. Peter Criss, the drummer for Kiss, said in a TV Guide interview, I find myself evil. I believe in the devil as much as God. You can use either one to get things done. One of the most popular groups in rock is AC/DC. In the song, Hell's Bells, they sing, I got my bell, I'm gonna take you to hell, I'm gonna get you, Satan get you. Their song Highway to Hell, they sing, Hey Satan, paying my dues, playing in a rockin' band, hey mama, look at me, I'm on the way to the promised land, I'm on the highway to hell. Angus Young, lead guitarist for AC/DC, is called the Guitar Demon. And he admitted that something takes control of the band during their concerts. It's like I'm on automatic pilot. By the time we're halfway through the first number, someone else is steering me. I'm just along for the ride. I become possessed when I get on stage. Hit Parader, July 1985, pages 60. The demonic Led Zeppelin, guitarist Jimmy Page of Zeppelin is a devout follower of Satanist, Aleister Crowley, who proclaimed himself as the Beast 666. In 1971, guitarist Jimmy Page bought Crowley's Boleskine house on the shore of Loch Ness, where Crowley practiced his hellish, satanic sex magic rituals, including human sacrifices. Jimmy Page opened a bookshop venture for occult books called Equinox at 4, on Holland Street, in Kensington, London. The Led Zeppelin song, Stairway to Heaven, played backwards can be heard to say, My sweet Satan. The one will be sad who makes me sad, whose power is Satan. Forward the lyrics say, Yes, there are two paths you can go by. But in the long run there's still time to change the road you're on. Listen for yourself, and you be the judge. The song has not been altered in any way. If you think this is just a hoax, then try it for yourself. The group Suicidal Tendencies, whose songs glorify suicide and have been linked to teen suicides, reveal a frightening truth in the song Possessed. I'm a prisoner of a demon, it stays with me wherever I go, I can break away from its hold, this must be my punishment for selling my soul. The song Sympathy for the Devil by the Rolling Stones is the official anthem for the Church of Satan. In it, Lucifer speaks in the first person and asks sympathy for all who meet him. Lead singer Mick Jagger claims that Anton LaVey, the founder of the Church of Satan and author of the Satanic Bible, help inspire their music. Their album titled, Their Satanic Majesty's Request, leaves no doubt to their allegiance. The more I research the history of rock and roll, the more I am shocked as to just how satanic the whole industry is. Few people would think of the Beach Boys as being involved with witchcraft, but as you will learn in this video, they certainly were. We were doing witchcraft, trying to make witchcraft music. Brian Wilson quoted in Nick Kent's The Dark Stuff, pages 27. As with many other rockers, Santana admits that there is a spiritual entity behind his music. Santana claims that he has had contact with the dead spirit of Jimi Hendrix. Santana claims that his first initiation into the spiritual world took place when he first ingested the illegal drug LSD in the 1960s. Other musicians, such as Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys, claim to have experienced type of spirit control. Santana claims that while he played Woodstock, the mecca of rock and roll, his guitar became a serpent before his eyes and inspired the way he played, which has made him famous as a rock guitarist. Santana admits that his success is tied to a spiritual entity, Metatron. Thus, Santana is of the devil. Through meditation, Santana said in Rolling Stone magazine, March 16, 2000, pages 41, that demonic spirits tell him what to write for his lyrics and music. You meditate and you got the candles, you got the incense and you've been chanting, and all of a sudden you hear this voice. Write this down. In his autobiography The Dogfather, Snoop Dogg says the devil came to him to make a deal that he would be rich and famous in exchange for his soul. Snoop accepted the devil's offer, by his own words, and identifies at the point at which Calvin Brodus dies Snoop Dogg was born. Ozzy Osbourne was a high school dropout and juvenile delinquent who spent time in prison for theft before he made his deal with the devil. Osbourne claims that he was drawn to Satan from the time of his childhood. I've always had this thing about Satan from the time I was small. The devil is within us all the time. Circus, August 26, 1980, pages 26. Sadly, Ozzy sought to find acceptance and success by opening himself up to dark satanic powers that are always seeking to exploit willing and open mediums. Ozzy would admit at the pinnacle of his success with Black Sabbath that he believed he was a medium for forces greater than himself who had given him such fame and accomplishment. Ozzy stated, "I don't know if I'm a medium for some outside source. Whatever it is, frankly, I hope it's not what I think, Satan." Hit Parader, February 1975, pages 24. The spirit behind most secular music is satanic. Many artists have admitted to selling their souls to Satan for fame and fortune. Many artists have also admitted themselves to channeling or being a conduit for evil spirits to create or perform their music. Remember, these are the artists saying themselves and the people around them that have said they are possessed or feel like the music is channeled through them. Tori Amos said, "I think music comes through dimensions. It's arrogant to think you can create music on your own. There's a co-creation going on. I don't know with whom, but there is this well that we all tap into." She once said, "I wanted to marry Lucifer. I don't consider Lucifer an evil force. I feel his presence with his music. I feel like he comes and sits on my piano." She even made a song dedicated to Lucifer. In the following performance, this should pretty much say it all.
"Go to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal."
In one interview, Van Halen's David Lee Roth said, "I'm gonna abandon my spirit to them, which is exactly what I attempt to do. You work yourself up into that state and you fall into supplication of the demon gods." Guitarist Mick Mars of Motley Crue described his band as demonic. "That's what we are," in Heavy Metal Times, May 1983. Nikki Sixx, referring to their Shout at the Devil stage show, commented, "We have skulls, pentagrams, and all kinds of satanic symbols on stage. I've always flirted with the devil," in Circus Magazine, January 31, 1984. Griffey, the producer for Dr. Dre, said, "I was there when Dre said he sold his soul to the devil for $1 million. And I swear, the devil got a receipt for his ass." Rapper Lil Wayne doesn't seem to be hiding the fact that he is a Satanist in his video for Love Me featuring Future and Drake, a song in which Wayne says these hoes love me like Satan, basically saying that Satan loves him. The video is disturbing to say the least, complete with evil imagery including women bathing in blood. The video also features demonic-looking women locked up in cages. Some of the women even have reptilian-like forked tongues thanks to computer graphics. The flame from the lighter at the beginning of the video creates a silhouette of Baphomet. And a satanic music video wouldn't be complete without the all-seeing eye being symbolized by the covering of one eye. This model's eye is even being covered by a butterfly, the symbol for monarch mind control programming. Miley Cyrus' dad, Billy Ray Cyrus, told GQ he is scared for his daughter's future in the spotlight. On February 15, 2011, Billy Ray Cyrus told GQ, "My family is under attack by Satan. I'm scared for my daughter Miley." Billy Ray didn't place all the blame on those currently in Miley's life. "There are also evil forces at work," he claimed. "Somewhere along this journey, both mine and Miley's faith has been shaken," he said. "It saddens me the most." His family, Billy Ray argued, is now being ruined by Satan. "No doubt," he insisted. "There's no doubt about it."
And of course, Rihanna is in the building.
Hey, Angie.
I cannot believe it's been so long that we have done this.
You know, I am misunderstood a lot at times. My music, my image, people have their whole thing about me, whether it be me being a devil worshiper or whatever, besides them reading into my hand over my eye on my album cover.
Why is your hand over your eye?
Because I'm a devil worshiper. What are you talking about?
Kesha admits she worships Satan in her song Dancing with the Devil. This shouldn't come as a surprise, though, because the pop star has posted pictures on her Facebook page of her wearing satanic pentagram earrings, and it's pretty obvious if you know anything about her. Nicki Minaj admits to being possessed by a demon spirit named Roman. Just when you thought the whole Illuminati demon possession by certain artists was a hoax, you may change your mind when you watch this confession from Nicki Minaj as she talks about the demon spirit that lives inside of her.
"Man is a crazy boy who lives in me, and he says the things that I don't want to say. He was born, just a few months ago. I think he was born out of rage. He was conceived in rage. So he bashes everyone. He threatens to beat people, and he's violent."
"That must be nice to have, like, an ignorant loudmouth who you can just sort of blame every..."
"He wants to be blamed. I don't want to blame him. I ask him to leave, but he can't. He's here for a reason. People have brought him out. People conjured him up. Now he won't leave."
Satan even offered Jesus the kingdoms of the world. "If Jesus worshipped him, so surely he can offer people fame and fortune if you served him." Satan is using music to pull people away from God and to corrupt people's hearts and souls. Satan certainly has musical abilities. It is believed he was a minister of music in heaven before he got kicked out because iniquity was found in him. This can be found in Ezekiel 28:13.
Dave Mustaine is one of the gods of metal, a founding member of Metallica, and the founder and frontman for Megadeth. He says he has no doubt about the devil.
"The greatest lie he's ever told was convincing people he doesn't exist. And you see people, they think that he's like red, he's got a goatee and a pointy tail and stuff like that. He doesn't. He's very beautiful. He's an angel. Why would he look like some monster? He's capable of looking just like you. He could be in this room right now. We wouldn't know it."
That's a scary thought.
It's a very scary thought.
Mustaine is currently on tour in Europe with what's called the Big Four, his current and former bands, plus Anthrax and Slayer.
Are people right when they say that heavy metal music is infused with the power of the devil?
In some cases, yes, but yes. Not in all cases, because you've got great heavy metal bands that believe in God and glorify him. We pray every night before we go on stage.
That sounds great.
For a 50-year-old
50-year-old man, I feel pretty damn good.
He shows me a chord progression called the tritone, also known as the devil's interval.
The devil's tritone is made up of these three notes, and this note right here drops down one. So it goes. So listen to the difference. It just sounds evil, doesn't it?
It sounds darker.
Which is why the progression is used so frequently in death metal. Mustaine says he is a Christian now, but wasn't always.
My mom was a Jehovah's Witness. I was brought up as a witness, and I revolted into the witchcraft because I hated going out and knocking on people's doors.
Yes, witchcraft. As a teenager, Mustaine says, he cast two hexes. The first was on a bully who sucker punched him.
From what I heard, he got in a car accident, and something happened to part of his body that I had targeted in the hex, and that showed me that it was real.
The second was on a girl he was in a class with.
Everybody wanted her, including me, but she was so out of my batting average and just totally out of my league. And I did it, and the next day she was in my apartment.
You were convinced that these hexes, that you were spells that you were casting, worked.
I was, and I do believe in the dark side. Most people think that, you know, black magic and witchcraft and stuff like that isn't real or it doesn't work. And I know that it works.
Mustaine's fascination with the occult continued into his adulthood.
I was doing a lot of blood packs with people. This is before we found out about AIDS. It was real simple stuff where you cut your thumb and you rub it with somebody else and become blood brothers. I don't want to make a spiritual covenant and mixing my life with somebody else who I don't know who they are or how they are. The Bible said that blood is life.
And like so many people we have met, Mustaine believes that he opened the door to demonic forces, which had a profound impact on his life.
Was your abuse of alcohol related to the satanic influences that you'd been dabbling in?
I'll say this. Every time I drank, I did not always do activities that were satanic, but any time I had been doing anything that was satanic, I had been drinking.
So
does that make sense?
Yes, it does. There was a relationship then.
Absolutely.
There are some songs Mustaine will no longer sing. I am an antichrist. Like Megadeth's cover of the Sex Pistols' Anarchy in the UK. And he says he believes he's better for it.
I think that I'm more dangerous now that I've become a Christian than I ever was before when I was trying to go the opposite route, because I'm armed with the truth now.
I sat on a council of 13 people that take orders only from the Rothschild Tribunal in London, which they claim they take their orders directly from Lucifer.
I was the manager of Zodiac Productions. Which Zodiac Productions, its name's been changed since then. I'm not even sure what to call it now, but it's the largest music conglomerate in the world. It owns RCA Records, Columbia Records, Motown Records, owns almost all the concert booking agencies in the United States. And that's not even the name of the company that owns it. The name of the company that owns it is Brenner Enterprises. And Brenner Enterprises is owned by Chase Manhattan. Chase Manhattan's owned by Standard Oil, and Standard Oil's owned by the Lords of London. You can track it all back. You kind of get the idea after a while. But I was the managing president of Zodiac Productions. It's one of my jobs as being one of these 13 people. Thus, I got to know many of the people who produce music and sing the music and play the music that you play. Now, one of the closest friends that I got during that time that I obtained was a man named David Crosby, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. I saw David the day before Christmas last year, talked with him. I got him away from this witch that he had with him. He told her to go shopping. We were in West Hollywood, and I was witnessing around to people I knew. We went off in this store, and we started talking. I said, David, I'd like to ask you a couple questions. I said, I already know the answers, but I've been gone for 5 years. I'd like to know if certain things are still the way they were when I left. I said, I'll have to explain some of this when I'm done, because you're not going to understand it all unless you know something about music. I said, do they still take the master to the temple room? Dave said, yeah. I said, do they still have the coven conjure demons into the master? He said, of course. I said, now, I got to know something. What's the main reason for rock music? He said, come on, Lance, you know what the reason is. I said, please, David, I don't want to guess. Tell me what the main reason is. He said, the same as when you were in, so that we can place spells on people that we couldn't cast spells upon. I'll explain what that means in a minute. I said, okay, one last thing. I've been hearing that you must be an initiated witch now to get a record contract. He said, that's right. He says, many of us that weren't total witches have to be witches now in order to produce music. Said, thank you. The master is a tape about as big as the top of this podium that looks like an overgrown 8-track that the album is cut on and is placed in a machine that produces and presses the records and the 8-tracks and cassettes that you buy. After it's been recorded, it's taken in. This is why a master's cut months in advance before it's released. On the full moon, it's taken in to a temple room about the size of this auditorium that is in every one of the major music companies behind locked doors up in the executive offices. And it's placed on an altar sitting in the north of the room and a pentagram engraved in the floor. And 13 hand-chosen witches and wizards and a coven come in and conjure a principality or a power up, usually Regia or something like that, and order him to tell the demons under him to follow every record and every tape coming off of that master. As I tell many Christian parents, you can go home and count your kids' records, probably yours too, and count how many demons at least are there. If that's too hard for you to believe, I'm sorry. That's why they do it. Now listen to me. This is why rock music's addicting. Have you ever seen kids that got rid of their music? They go around like this. They can't wait to find a rock station somewhere and they sneak off just like getting a cigarette or a fix because it's addicting. That's why they can't give it up. The rest of the conversation was this. You can't cast a spell on a Christian, but you can get a Christian to cast a spell on themselves. If you give the permission for the spell to work, being a Christian won't block it. And rock music is not just a song. It is supernatural music that witches carefully designed by their spirit guides or familiar spirits in the form of spells. Now, although the devil's music's power is the music and God's music is the word, much of the songs are written in what we call witch language. To give you kind of an idea, you talk on, many of you talk on a CB, unless you know what a smoky is, and a 10-4, and a front door and back door and rocking chair and these type of things, you don't know what you're talking about. Same with witches. When you're in the first and second level, you have to learn over 2,000 words that said by anybody else means something totally different than when you say them. Elton John has said he's never written a song or sung a song that wasn't in witch language. And I want to show you something. See how many kids in here will be honest and adults. How many remember and have heard at least several times a song called Hotel California? Somebody tell me what it meant. Quickly, somebody tell me what it meant. Huh? That's pretty close. But from the word, what did it mean? Well, that's more of a guess. See, most people can't tell you. That's why when people do drugs and they listen to songs in which language, they get some of the meaning. But most of the time, they can't tell you. Stop and think how many songs are out there that you really like, and you don't have any idea what the person was talking about. Beyond the Yellow Brick Road? How about The Destroyer by Kiss? Can anybody tell me what it's about? Kiss said in it, kids, kill your parents. They're talking about Helter Skelter. Beatles sung Helter Skelter in which language nobody knew what it meant. Manson did because he belonged to the process. Helter Skelter is a several thousand year old word. Most of the music is either about Helter Skelter or a place called the Night Winds, which is what Hotel California is about, and different doctrines of witchcraft. You listen to them, your parents let you listen to them, and they have no idea. Kiss openly bragged how they were gaining control of people through their music because the people played their music. They told how they didn't form their own group. Their church, because they were ordained ministers of the Satanist church, placed them together. And that's how most of the music is done. David Crosby, when him and Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young produced the record 283, they ordered the principality of Medea to order demons of rebellion to go into the record, and everybody that heard it would be rebellious against law and order and government. And it was one of the reasons for the great upheaval in the 60s was that one album, and they take open credit for it.
Michael Jackson was heavily involved in the occult. He admitted he had a room full of mirrors so he could communicate with a spirit. Jackson said he would go to sleep for days with the aid of drugs so he can get songs from the spirits, or else the music of the spirits would be given to Prince. Jackson said, "I wake up from dreams and go, wow, put this down on paper, the whole thing is strange. You hear the words, everything is right there in front of your face. I feel that somewhere, someplace it's been done, and I'm just a courier bringing it into the world." Michael Jackson, Rolling Stone, February 17, 1983.
How do you write a song? How do you write a song?
How do I write a song? Well,
you don't if have I a sat pen down in your hand piano, and you don't try, what would happen?
If I sat here and played some chords, whatever, and say, I'm going to write the best song I've ever written, nothing happens. Something in the heavens has to say, look, this is the time that this is going to be laid on you, and this is when I want you to have it. Now, I remember when I wrote Billie Jean, I was riding in my car down Ventura Boulevard. All I said to myself beforehand, I want to write a song with a great bass hook, you know, and I just let it go, really. And then several days later, you know, you know, the whole
thing. Where did that come from?
From above.
So, okay, you were singing the bass line. Sing that again, and then what happened? How did you get the other instrumentation and the composition? How did it work?
See, the thing is, artists seem to get in the way of the music. Get out of the way of the music. You know, don't write the music. Let the music write itself.
Prince admitted he had two other people living inside him, really evil spirits, and that he changed his name to formerly known as Prince because he didn't know what the spirits wanted to call him. Rapper Jay-Z shown here wearing a shirt that is displaying Aleister Crowley's Do What Thy Wilt satanic motto. Even though Jay-Z denies being involved in the occult, Jay-Z has been caught several times with his hand in the Illuminati cookie jar. He named his record company Rockefeller Records, naming it after the infamous Illuminati family, the Rockefellers. Jay-Z even released a song paying homage to Lucifer, entitled Lucifer.
I sold my soul.